Well, this is going to be a laugh on many levels. What do we have? Another wonderful Gibson product with bitey, sharp fret ends. And this adventure started out with a simple task you can perform at home, putting your knobs on. But unfortunately, when it came time to take that knob off, the control shaft wanted to come with it. Which brings us to our next dilemma. Let's have a look inside and see what can be done. And look what we have. We have the, I am definitely sure, fabricated somewhere not in America circuit board. Okay, well, it's got to come out of there for me to fix this. And I believe this is all plug and play. What happens here if I pull that? Oh, you guys. Okay, this could be fun. Might be easier, instead of getting my big ham hands in there, let's just release the circuit board from the other side. I think this one I can get. Maybe not. Push and pull, that's it. And this guy too, push and pull. Yep. The pickups themselves are a little more fiddly. I can't get my hands in there. So, let's take all the hardware off and get it apart. Oh, I know you guys like swearing. And this could be a candidate for it. Come on. That one's really bitchy. I have a tool for that. Let me find it. I think this is like a... pretty sure it's for pulling integrated circuits out of sockets. But with any luck, I can grab that little connector. I can't get my fingers in there. Which is the releasing side. Okay. See, I'm not swearing yet, guys, but I haven't broken anything yet either. Oh, really? Come on. There we go. Finally. Damn. Come on out. Okay, that piece of shit's out of there. Oh, look at this. You can't even go buy one of those. Because, you know why? Because that's a whole special long shaft. Well, maybe a long shaft can work. Ground lug. 3 points to desolder there. I don't know, guys. Like I said, I took a look on the Confuser, and guys want like 60, 80 bucks for one of these used on eBay. Well, what should I do? I think I should stop for a minute and think about it. I'm just heating up the old soldering machine and looking for, oh, we found it, the desoldering wick and probably the solder sucker. Oh, it's over there too. Anyway, you guys get what goes on here, right? Gibson, to save probably a lot of money, got rid of everybody that had skill and used to solder everything together. And then, you know, you can pay, you don't even have to pay anybody. A machine can plug all these parts in. And the machine wave solders over it and it's done. So, you see where that went. But this is not user friendly. What's the first thing you want to do with your Les Paul after you want to try something different? Oh, here's another great Gibson quality control. That whole cavity's all ratted and full of sawdust. But, yeah,
So, you know, let's save dough. Think my rod is hot enough yet. Let's save dough, and this is what you get. Can't be fixed, can't be modified, and well, I shouldn't say it can't be fixed. I haven't got there yet, but like I said, I think a long shaft pot will make it, and then I'll have to bend the leads over, trim them, stick them in the hole. I think I can. I just got to find a pot, and then, you know, I'm in Kanukistan, right, guys? So it's like, come on. What's going on with my iron? A little tinning, perhaps. Getting a lot of heat transfer. I'm going to have to pull out the fat one. Right? The fat soldering. Soldering. You guys drive me nuts. What'd you guys use on this? I'm going to pull out the big one. Well, that was somewhat successful. There wasn't really any swearing. Now, gee, well, what do you think, guys? I'm gonna go to the store, see if I can find one, and yeah, wish me luck. And always remember, guys, if it smells like chicken, you're holding it wrong. Just saying. Okay, but hey, look what happened. We went to the store on a Sunday in Canada, and I actually found something. That in itself is a small miracle. So, my next magic trick will be to trim the little eyelets off the end of that, plug it back in there, and re-snodder it in place. Sorry about the fan noise, guys. I'm just sucking solder fumes out of the general area. Hey, look at that. That worked out. Put this guy back on here. Like that. Something like that. Let's put it back together. Hey. Actually worked. Now let's play with the sharp thread ends. And away we go. I already did those two. Usually I like to put on some of my favorite tunes when I'm doing this, because it's just one of those jobs, right? Oh, how nice it's going to be. Well, that's pretty much it for this one. Thank you, Gibson, for the shitty circuit board, which you see is serviceable, but, you know. Sounds pretty cool. That's it. Sharp fret end's gone. Broken pot. What did we do? Truss rod set. Intonation set. Pickup height set. Everything checks out A-OK. Guys, thanks for all the support. Thanks for hanging out with me. Become a patron. Like me on Facebook. Twitter me. What else is there? Twitter, Patreon, Facebook. That's as much as I can handle. Anyway, cheers, folks.